As now, more than 550,000 Americans have died from COVID. We take this moment to remember five of the remarkable lives lost. Earnestine Jake Lehi was known as Grandma Ernie to family and even friends, her daughter told us. Born in Cedar City, Utah, Earnestine was the last fluent speaker of the Paiute language for the Indian Peaks Band of Utah.
Moana piano niyakan Carl Mini Jake. Why you ni patingo want Anthony and Janine?
A lifelong member of her tribe, Earnestine devoted her career to teaching and writing about her native culture. Her family says she also loved dancing at powwows and was a natural storyteller who could make everyone laugh. Earnestine was 76. 101-year-old Marianne Steiner was the epitome of elegance, her grandson told us. Born in Germany to a well-known Jewish family, she escaped Nazi rule and fled to New York City in 1938. She later fell in love and married another Jewish immigrant, book publisher Paul Steiner. The couple loved hosting parties, and Marianne was always the center of attention, her family said. She loved reading and traveling and urged people to make time for fun. At her own 100th birthday party, she said just being alive was still so exciting. No matter what life threw at Marcella Noah Bailey, she always had a smile on her face, her friends and family said. Born in Mexico, Noah moved to Arizona in 2001. She worked mainly as a housing specialist in Phoenix, helping low-income residents find places to live. A single working mom, she also drove for Uber on nights and weekends. In her free time, she loved hiking and taking pictures of the sunrise. But more than anything, she cherished spending time with her two sons. Noah was 41. 77-year-old Thomas Boykoff was a self-described nerd who was always up for a good laugh, his son told us. Born in New York, Thomas moved to Madison, Wisconsin for college and later worked as a lawyer for the Wisconsin state government. He loved reading the stories of Sherlock Holmes and biographies of presidents he felt history had forgotten, especially Millard Fillmore. He also frequently wrote to world leaders and collected responses from several, including the Pope, the Dalai Lama, and the Queen of England. Born in Natchez, Mississippi, Don Brooks grew up in a sharecropping family. He met his future wife, Gloria, as a teenager, and the pair became inseparable for more than six decades. Don was a pretty cool dude, his wife told us, and he always treated me right. He loved playing golf and worked for 52 years at the Carnegie Institution for Science in Washington, D.C., mainly as a building maintenance specialist. His family said he was excited about retiring this year. Don was 75. And we are so grateful to families for sharing these stories with us. Our hearts go out to you as they do to all who've lost loved ones in this pandemic.